Hello, good evening and welcome back to my channel. My name is Okocha Pimase. Thank you for coming across this video. Today, I want to speak with you about your legal right in Christ. Your legal right in Christ. There is this thing that happens about 6 to 7 years ago. There is a friend of mine that did a wrong thing contrary to the law, and he was arrested and sent to prison. He was sent to 3 years imprisonment. Then when he was arrested, because of what he did, the police had legal right to put him into the prison, to drag him even with force, even to beat him up, because he did a wrong thing, which is contrary to the law. He disobeyed the law. So the police now had right against him. Then he was taken to prison to serve his punishment, to pay the price of the wrongdoing that he has done. Then after 3 years, he was released. And the day he was released, I was a witness. I was there. Then as he was coming out of the prison, there is an inscription that was written on his clothes. And what could that be? Fully paid. Fully paid. That was what they wrote on his note. Fully paid. In other words, this person is free. He is free from the legal charges. He is free from everything that he have done wrong. He have paid fully. And this is another thing that I noticed there. The group of police, the legal right of police that took him, that abducted him when he did something that was wrong and contrary to the law, was the same police that was there looking at him, but they don't have a legal right against him anymore because he has paid his price. They don't have legal right against him anymore. They were greeting him. They were telling him bye. Some were telling him thank God. Some were telling him different ways. They don't have any right again against him. Why? Because he had paid the price. Now, this is where I'm going to. This is the reason why I'm telling you this story. You know, your legal right in Christ is something that you must know. Your legal right in Christ gives you freedom in so many areas and endeavors of your life. Your legal right, because we were like somebody that was in prison. We were like people that were in prison. But Christ came and paid the price for us. He died for us. He purchased us. So we are legal property of Jesus Christ. So as a legal property of Jesus Christ, and he has paid and bought us with his precious blood, we need to recognize, we need to appreciate, we need to know our stand in Christ. When you don't know about your legal authority and legal right in Christ, you live in a life where you don't have any authority. You don't know any authority to exercise. Whatever you don't know on time, we waste your time. That is why Hosea chapter 4 verse 6 says, "My people perish because of the lack of knowledge." He did not say my people perish because they are sinners. He did not say my people perish because they did not pray. My people perish because they did not do this or that. He said my people perish because of the lack of knowledge. Now, in this very moment of our life, the knowledge about our legal right in Christ cannot be undermined. In this delicate world that we are living, where everything bad is happening, when you talk about the health issues, the rumors of war, the tensions of war everywhere, the maladministration of government officials, just to mention but few, when you look at everything that is happening in this world, the only thing and the only solution to the problems of mankind is the kingdom of God, which Jesus Christ asks us to seek first in Matthew 6:33, and which he asks us to pray for in Matthew chapter 6. Now, the important of your legal right in Christ, it makes you to understand that you don't belong to the system of the world, that you have a legal right in another country, in another government that has authority, that has power above everything that is going on in this life. That is why when you are sick, sometimes you can speak to a sick person, or you can speak to the situation you are as yourself. The sickness will just disappear. The sickness will go out. When you see somebody that is lame, you can speak to the person. That is all about a legal authority. A legal authority. When you have a legal authority, you don't use your physical power to do things again. Let me give you another example. If, for example, a police, a custom, depends the name it is being called in your country, the people that checkmate goods and services, or just a normal police, if a police want to stop a vehicle that is going on the road, the police will not just come out on the road and start pushing the vehicle back. No, the police will just give a sign. Either he will raise up his hand, or he will flag a sign, or he will bring out a sign like stop, the vehicle will stop. Now, what stops the vehicle is not the power of the police, but the authority that has been invested in the police. So, when you recognize your legal authority, you don't use your physical power any longer. You use that legal authority. And that legal authority is what we need in this world, where so many sickness have no cure, where so many wars have no solution, where so many situations we are seeing has no solution. And that applies that there is no solution to the problem of mankind except the kingdom of God. And that is why we must continue to seek, to pray, and to do what God has done. Of the world today, what they are thinking or what they normally think is all about going to another world, going to where they will be a better person, going to heaven, you know, like Hindu, they call it a peaceful state of mind, you know, Muslim call it paradise, Christian call it heaven. But the reason why all of them are thinking about this heaven and want to go to heaven, it's not because they really want to go to heaven. They want to go to a place where there will not be death, where there will not be sorrow, where there will not be weeping, where there will not be this and that. And that is the kingdom God has promised you on earth. And He is coming back to install it. And that is the essence of the second coming of Jesus Christ. That is what He is coming to do. He is not coming to judge you. He is not coming to judge you. So Jesus Christ is coming to install His kingdom on earth, and His kingdom is going to reign forever. So this video is a call to recognize your legal authority in Christ. Recognize your legal authority in Christ. It's something that you can never do without. Recognize your legal authority in Christ. When you recognize it, you use it against every situation that you find yourself. The legal authority you have in Christ is above your sickness. It's above even your financial state. It will give you wisdom. It will give you authority over Satan, over sin, over any kind of things you can think and thought of. And when you do this, you will see the glory of God around you. Thank you for having time to listen to this video. I am Okocha Happy Marcel. Shalom.